When you're lying awake with a dismal headache of repose is taboo'd by anxiety, I conceive you may use any language you choose to indulge in without impropriety. For your brain is on fire, the bedclothes conspire of usual slumber to plunder you. First your counter-pane goes and uncovers your toes, and your she slips demurely from under you. The blanketing tickles you feel like mixed pickles, so terribly sharp is the pricking. And your heart and your cross and your tumble and toss till there's nothing twixt you and the ticking. Then the bedclothes will creep into the ground in a heap, and you pick them all up in a tangle. Next your pillow resigns and politely declines to remain at its usual angle. Will you get some repose in the form of a doze with hot eyeballs and head ever aching? But your slumbering teams with such horrible dreams that you'd very much better be waking. For you feel you are crossing the channel and tossing about in a steamer for marriage, which is something between a large bathing machine and a very small second-class carriage. And you're giving a treat penny, ice and cold meat to a party of friends and relations. But a ravenous horde, and they all came on board at Slumber and South Kensington stations. And bound on that journey, you find your attorney who started that morning from Devon. He's a bit undersized, and you don't feel surprised when he tells you he's only 11. Well, you're riding like mad with the singular lad. By the pie, the ship's now a four-wheeler. And you're playing our games, and he calls you bad names, and you tell him the ties with the dealer. Well, this you can't stand, so you throw up your hands, and you find it as cold as an icicle. And your shirt and your socks are black silk with gold gosh crossing stars, but he played on a bicycle. And he and the crew are on bicycles too, which they've somehow or other invested in. And he's telling the tars all the particulars of a company he's interested in. It's a scheme of devices to get at low prices, or goods from cloth mixtures to cables, which tickled the sailors by treating retailers as though they were all vegetables. You get a good spaceman to plant a small tradesman, first take off his boots with a boot tree, and his legs will take root and his fingers will shoot till they blossom and butt like a fruit tree. From the green grocer tree you get grape and green pea, cauliflower, pineapples and cranberry, while the pastry cook plant cherry panties for grand apple puffs and three corners and bamberries. The shares of a penny and ever so many are taken by Rothschild and Banning. And just as a few were allotted to you, you awake with a shudder despairing. You're a regular wreck with a crick in your neck and no wonder your snoggles, your head's on the floor and your needles and pins from your associations and your fletches are creep because your left legs are sleep as a cramp and your tails and a fly and your nose is a puff and you're not gonna be but it's tangled and there's this intense in a general sense that you haven't been sleeping in clover. But the darkness has passed and it's daylight at last and the night has been long, ditto, ditto, my song. And thank goodness they're both of them.